20 years ago, Elvis Presley died, but that wasn't the end of the Elvis story. Within 3 days of his death, a new chapter was just beginning.
Already the myths are being manufactured. I've met fans who say they're convinced he's still alive. On articles attacking the man have been written, saying that he believed he had supernatural powers and he would be reincarnated.
As the snow flies on a cold and gray Chicago morning, a poor little baby child is born in the ghetto.
It touches my heart, just touches my soul, everything really. Just seems to envelop you in him, in his voice.
Need is another hungry mouth to feed in the ghetto.
I couldn't imagine life without him. I mean, yes, I know he's dead, but to us he's not.
He'll grow to be an angry young man someday.
I was told by the voice coming out of the light, go back and tell them Elvis.
Do we simply turn our heads and look the other way?
Elvis was something special. He really was. I don't want to be sacrilegious, but he's Jesus-like.
And a hungry little boy with a runny nose plays in the street as the cold wind blows in the ghetto.
At Graceland, Elvis Presley's Memphis home, the Christmas decorations stay up for an extra 3 days to celebrate the birth of the king of rock and roll. Elvis was born on January the 8th, 1935, into a poor white American home in Bible Belt, Mississippi. He was the surviving twin of a difficult labor and became Vernon and Gladys Presley's only and particularly precious child. 60 years on, just a few mementos of the early days survive, some kept in a glass case in the Memphis Music Hall of Fame, and others in the largely rebuilt and refurbished shack in the small town of Tupelo, where Elvis was born and the legend begins.
Vernon was so nervous waiting for this baby to be born that he walked outside to have a cigarette. He said the wind was blowing and it was freezing cold, and I lit up a cigarette and I looked up and I thought I saw a blue light over the house.
Some fans have turned the events of his birth into a strangely familiar story. Elvis, they say, was born in a house little bigger than a stable. And at the moment of his birth,
a light had shone so brightly on the little house which he was born that Vernon actually had his way lit to the well. He could see his way to the well for water that night. And also all the medicine bottles started vibrating very loudly on the shelves during, you know, when Elvis was born, the moments when he was born.
In a cardboard shack with a rubber tin, where there ain't pressed down anything within. The young mother frozen on the concrete floor, and a bundle in a box and a cradle of straw.
Elvis's life is the American dream. From humble beginnings, he rose to become the music world's biggest star.
He still is the king, really, because although there's been lots of princes and would-be kings, they come and they go, don't they? And they still don't have that, the kind of charisma that he had that touched a generation. And so I don't think there's been anybody quite like him, and I think he will always be the king as far as I'm concerned.
Elvis came first, and everyone else has followed, interpreting the poses and music, which in the beginning were Elvis. Here, a Finnish professor performs Elvis songs in Latin at a conference on Elvis and the Sacred South, held in the summer of 96, which brought academics, artists, and fans from around the world to Oxford, Mississippi.
Of course, for academics and scholars who are interested in the broad picture and delving beneath the surface, we would like to educate the world about high culture, low culture, popular culture, spur of the moment, serendipity, and Elvis is at the center of a new way of bringing ideas and yearnings and desires and needs together, Elvis's appeal is religious to many people. It's, I would say, maybe more spiritual than religious in the sense that it's not localized in a congregation, although there have been attempts to do that.
So is it spirituality which underpins the dedication of the truly faithful Elvis fan?
Just like it takes over your life type of thing. I've got to listen to him every day. Or see him on the telly every day. It's just this need that you can't explain to anybody. It's just like being in another world. It's a lot of people don't understand that, you know, they think you're on another planet type of thing. They can't understand when you're talking about him, and you know, it's only like to a real Elvis fan to communicate with.
What about the bears?
Oh, the bears. Well, these ones. Press the tummy in. And they all play a tune. My husband bought me the first one. In fact, this was the first one he ever bought me. And I just collected them. And there was only one I couldn't get hold of, which is Are You Lonesome Tonight? But I eventually got that last August in Memphis. So that's my collection complete.
Are you lonesome tonight? Do you miss?
It's just the lyrics and the song and how he sings. There's so much feeling in his songs. The emotion. If I feel very depressed, I put on an Elvis song. And it just calms me down. Or if I'm stressed out, put an Elvis record on. And it just relaxes you. It just seems to float.
Really is a fascinating example of the way a religious enthusiasm begins. You see, again, in the Western world, we often think of religion as a doctrine, a message, and we have to prove to ourselves that it is true, and then we'll apply it. But that's not actually the way religions work. People live in a certain way. They perform certain rituals, and through that, they discover faith.
It's Easter Day, and Elvis fans meet in the upper room of a pub in Wolverhampton.